Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum dear students. In the previous lecture we had started with the topic of somatic sensations and we talked about the tactile sensations in which we studied the touch sensation and we studied about the itch and tickle. Today we are going to continue with the somatic sensation topic and we are going to learn two more of the tactile sensations which include the vibration sense and proprioception, and we are going to study the nociceptive sensation which is the pain sensation. So we start with our lecture. First we are going to talk about the vibration sense. Now vibration sense is basically it is phasic pressure, and it is defined as rapid rhythmic and repetitive pressure stimuli. These are perceived as vibration. Again, I am repeating that rapid, rhythmic, repetitive pressure stimuli are perceived as vibration. When you place a vibrating tuning fork on some part of your body, you feel a buzzing sensation. This buzzing sensation that you feel when you put a vibrating tuning fork on a part of body, this buzzing sensation is called as vibration. Low frequency vibration is detected or perceived by Meissner's corpuscles. So the receptors for low frequency vibration are Meissner's corpuscles. They detect the vibration sense in the range of 2 to 80 cycles per second, while high frequency vibrations are detected by Pacinian corpuscles, which detect the vibration sense in the range of 30 to 800 cycles per second. So two types of receptors are there which detect the sense of vibration: Meissner's corpuscles and the Pacinian corpuscles. The Meissner's corpuscles detect the low frequency vibration and the Pacinian corpuscles detect the high frequency vibration. In this diagram you can see how the sense of vibration is checked. You place a vibrating tuning fork on a part of your body, usually over the bony prominence, and you feel a buzzing sensation, which is your sense of vibration. Now from the receptors that are the Meissner's corpuscles and the Pacinian corpuscles, these signals are carried by type A beta fibers. Type A beta fibers carry these signals to the spinal cord, and in the spinal cord the signals are carried via the dorsal column. So in our subsequent lectures we are going to study about the ascending tracts in the spinal cord, which are the sensory tracts, and these tracts carry the sensation from periphery to the central nervous system. So one of the sensory tract is dorsal column, and it carries the impulses and or the sensation to the central nervous system in the spinal cord, and one of the sensation which is carried by it is the sense of vibration. Next is position sense. The sense of position is also known as proprioception. Proprioception or the position sense is the sense of movement of various parts of the body in relation to one another. So we have also talked about it previously, that proprioception or the position sense is related to the physical state of the body. And when we have to define it, we say that it is the sense of movement of various parts of body in relation to one another. Proprioception is of two types, static and kinesthetic. Static proprioception or static sense of position is conscious perception of orientation of different parts of the body. It is conscious perception, it is not constant, it is conscious perception ऑफ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ बॉडी इन रिलेशन टू वन एंड अदर. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द स्टैटिक सेंस ऑफ पोजिशन एंड इट इज द अवेयरनेस अबाउट डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी, ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ बॉडी वेन दे आर नॉट मूविंग. सो इन रिगार्ड टू दिस इट कैन बी सेड एज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो इट इज द अवेयरनेस ऑफ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी अबाउट द स्टैटिक पोजिशन. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज स्टैटिक प्रोप्रिसेप्शन और स्टैटिक पोजिशन सेंस. While kinesthetic position sense is the conscious perception of the rate of movement of different parts of body. So when there is change in the position of a part of body and brain perceive this change, that is the kinesthetic position sense. And when there is static position of part of body and it is not changing, that is called as the static position sense or static proprioception. So two types are there, static and kinesthetic. Now the receptors which detect the sense of position are called as proprioceptors, and proprioceptors include the muscle spindles. Muscle spindles are the receptors present in the muscles. We will study about these receptors in detail in conjunction with the stretch reflex. Golgi tendon organs are the receptors again present in the skeletal muscles, and we are going to study them in detail and their functions later on and how do they help in different functions, and that is what are their functions. And then are the Pacinian carpuscles and Roughneys and organs. So four proprioceptors are there: muscle spindles, Golgi tendon organs, both of which are present in the skeletal muscles, and Pacinian carpuscles and Roughneys and organ. The distribution of the Pacinian carpuscles and Roughneys and organs we have already discussed when we talked about the topic of sensory receptors. So these were the receptors about which carry the which detect the proprioception. Now these proprioceptive signals in the spinal cord are carried in the dorsal column. So we studied that vibration sense is carried in the dorsal column, and the sense of position or proprioception is also carried by the dorsal column tract in the spinal cord. So these were the tactile sensations that we discussed, and now we are going to start with the nociceptive sensation or the pain sensation. You must be remembering that in the previous lecture, when we started with the topic of somatic sensations, we classified the somatic sensations into three main categories. We said that there are tactile sensations, and we said that there are nociceptive sensation and thermal sensations. So we have finished the topic of tactile or the mechanoceptive sensations, and now we are going to move on to the pain sensation. Now pain sensation, it is an unpleasant sensation. It is an unpleasant sensation. It's a warning sign, like if there is a pain in some part of body, like pain when there is appendicitis, it causes a person to seek the medical advice. So it's a warning sign for some damage going on in the body. So when there is the pain sensation arises from some part of body, the person is going to seek cure for that. It is also protective in nature, like if your foot or your hand touches a pointed object, that part of the body, finger or the foot, is suddenly withdrawn. So you feel pain sensation and you withdraw your part of body. So it is protective in nature, and most importantly, it is non-adapting. We do not adapt to the pain sensation. Like we talked about the tactile sensations, that there is rapid adaptation in case of the tactile sensations, like the touch sensation. But pain sensation is non-adapting in nature. Pain sensation can be divided into two types. depending upon its quality or nature, fast pain and slow pain. This is one way of classifying the pain sensation. There are other ways as well. So according to the nature of the pain or according to the quality of the pain, it can be fast pain or the slow pain. The fast pain is also known as the sharp pain. And it has certain characteristic features. The qualities or the features of the sharp pain are that it is quick in onset. It is rapid in onset. It is sharp or pricking in nature. And has short duration. Sharp pain is well localized. On the other hand, the slow pain, which is also called as dull pain, it is slower in onset. It has a prolonged duration or a greater duration, and it is less well localized as compared to the sharp pain, and it is usually dull in nature, and it is a diffused pain, while sharp pain is, it is sharp and it is well localized, while slow pain, it is a dull pain, it is a diffused pain, and it is less well localized. The nerve fibers which carry the sharp pain or the fast pain are type A delta fibers. So from the receptors, type A delta fibers carry the sharp pain or the fast pain to the spinal cord, while slow pain is transmitted by type C fibers. In the spinal cord, the pain signals are carried in the lateral spinothalamic tract. So again, this is an ascending or the sensory pathway present in the spinal cord, and it carries the sensation of pain. Lateral spinothalamic tract carries the sensation of pain in the spinal cord through the central nervous system. Now here is the classification of the pain sensation or the types of the pain sensation. As I just told you that according to the quality of the pain, it can be fast and slow, the features of which we have studied. Then according to the region, we can classify the pain into superficial or visceral. We can combine the deep or the visceral pain as one category. So we can say there are two types of pain according to the origin of pain. Either it is superficial or cutaneous pain, or it is deep or the visceral pain. So these are different ways to divide the pain into different types. Now the stimuli which can cause pain sensation are the noxious stimuli. And noxious stimuli can be mechanical, thermal and chemical. Again, I am repeating that noxious stimuli can be mechanical, thermal and chemical. Now, example of mechanical stimuli which can give rise to pain sensation are a lot many things that you have observed in your daily life, like a pinprick, a cut with a sharp object like a knife. It is going to give rise to pain sensation, and this is a mechanical stimulus. Then heavy pressure can also give rise to the pain sensation. Then distension of a hollow viscera in your body can also give rise to pain sensation. Like distension of gut can give rise to pain sensation. Similarly, the intracranial pressure, when it is increased, it gives rise to pain sensation. And in the eyeball, if there is increased intraocular pressure, which puts pressure on the eyeball, so it gives rise to pain sensation. So different mechanical stimuli can give rise to pain sensation, and a few examples we have studied. Then thermal stimuli. Remember that extreme of heat and extreme of cold, both can give rise to pain sensation. burning hot and freezing cold both give rise to pain sensation. So thermal stimuli can also be there for the pain sensation. Extremely hot objects and extremely cold objects, sorry, extremely, yes, the extremely hot or extremely cold things can also give rise to the can give rise to the pain sensation. So burning hot and freezing cold. Then are the chemical stimuli that can give rise to pain sensation include the histamine, bradykinin, serotonin and substance P. So these are different chemicals which can give rise to pain sensation. So total we have done 3 types of noxious stimuli: mechanical, thermal and chemical, and we have seen the examples of each type of the stimulus as well. Now coming to the pain receptors. The pain receptors are called nociceptors and these are free nerve endings and these are non-adapting in nature. Now the pain receptors are present in the superficial layer of the skin and in the tissues like periosteum, meninges, pleura, peritoneum, mesentery and joint capsule. Some of the vistas of the body or some of the parts of the body are devoid of pain receptors. That is, they do not have pain receptors. These parts of the body include the following, like bone. So receptors, pain receptors are not present in the bone. Pain receptors are present in the periosteum. So stimulation of pain receptor in the periosteum give rise to the pain sensation that you feel like arising from bone. Bone itself does not have the pain receptors. Similarly, pain receptors are not present in the brain, but the meninges are the membranes, are the coverings of the brain which contain the pain receptors. Similarly, lungs and liver also do not have the pain receptors, and similar is the case with the spleen. Liver and spleen do not have the pain receptors, but the connective tissue capsule of the liver and spleen has the pain receptors. Similarly, lungs do not have the pain receptors, but it is the pleura which has the pain receptors. So, same is the case with the gut. The gut wall does not contain any receptor and it can be cut without any feeling of pain sensation. But it is the mesentery which contains the pain receptors. And similarly, skeletal muscles do not have the pain receptors, but these are the connective tissue coverings present in the skeletal muscles which contain the pain receptors. And when there is pressure on these connective tissue coverings, when these are stretched, they cause the pain sensation. They cause a feeling of pain sensation. But muscle fibers themselves do not contain the pain receptors. So this is the diagram showing us the various stimuli which can give rise to pain sensation, mainly the chemical stimuli. We talked about that histamine is there, so bradykinin is there, substance P is there, and serotonin can also cause the pain sensation. Now coming to the reactions to the pain, that is when you perceive pain, what is the reaction? So we can say that there are two aspects of pain sensation. One is perception, consciously becoming aware of a painful stimulus. The second aspect of pain sensation is reaction to pain. Now reaction to pain, it varies from person to person. Some people react not much to the painful stimuli, while other people react to a greater degree to the painful stimuli. Now reaction to pain or the sensitivity to pain, it also varies in among the races. Negroes have less pain sensitivity. They are less sensitive to pain. So we can say they do not feel much pain. So reaction to pain, it varies from one person to other person and also varies among the races. Now, reaction to pain can be divided into three groups. There are somatic reactions, there are autonomic reactions to pain, and emotional reactions to pain. Again, I'm repeating that reactions to pain are divided into three groups: somatic reactions, autonomic reactions, and emotional reactions. Now, somatic reactions include the withdrawal, like if your finger touches a pointed object, you will withdraw your finger. So this is a somatic reaction to pain. There is increased neuromuscular excitability, like if you the excitability of the nerve and muscles is increased, and there can be reflex spasm of the nearby muscles. Like if there is pain in some area of the body, the muscles in that area, in which are close to that source of pain or to the site of pain, they undergo spasm. Spasm is a sustained contraction of the muscles. So these are the somatic reactions to pain. Then autonomic reactions to pain can include either there can be stimulation of sympathetic nervous system, or there can be stimulation of parasympathetic nervous system. So there can be changes in the heart rate, there can be changes in the blood pressure, and there can be flushing or yellow or paleness of the skin. So I'm repeating again, in autonomic reactions there can be either stimulation of sympathetic nervous system or the parasympathetic nervous system. So there can be changes in the heart rate, blood pressure, there can be flushing, and there can be paleness of the skin. While emotional reactions can include like vocalization response, that crying in response to pain, there can be clenching, and there can be depression, anxiety, or worriness. So these are different emotional reactions to pain sensation. Now coming to the referred pain. In the beginning we talked about that pain can be classified according to its location into superficial and the deep pain. Superficial and the deep pain. Now deep pain is usually the visceral pain. And visceral pain, I just told you that it arises from the deeper visceras in the body, and it is usually dull or colicky in nature. Again, I'm repeating that one way to classify the pain sensation is divided into fast and slow, that is according to the quality of pain. The other way is according to the origin of the pain sensation, superficial or deep or visceral. So visceral pain jo hai, which arises from the visceras, it may be dull, diffuse pain, or it can be colicky pain. Ab colicky pain kaisi hoti hai? Colicky pain is episodic in nature. That is, there is an attack of pain and then after a particular duration the pain subsides and then it's come again after some time. So the pain that comes and goes is called as colicky pain, episodic pain. Now the pain that is visceral pain, it is usually referred to the distant structures. Pain which is arising from the visceras is referred to the other areas, usually on the skin, which is away from the site of pain. So that pain which is referred is called as the referred pain. So when we define it, we say it is the pain felt in an area of the skin, in the area of the skin which is away from the source or the origin of pain. Again, I'm repeating that referred pain is the pain felt in an area of the skin which is away from the source or the origin of pain. So I just told you that visceral pain is referred to the distant structures, and distant structures usually is the skin, surface of the skin. Now The referred pain has the dermatomal rule. The cause or the basis of the referred pain is dermatomal rule. कि क्यों एक visceral pain refer हो जाती है, feel होती है on the surface of the skin which is actually away from that viscera. So basis is dermatomal rule. And what is that dermatomal rule? The reason is that the structure or the viscera from where the pain is arising and the part of the body where it is referred both receive the sensory innervation from the same segment of the spinal cord. Again I am repeating that viscera jahan se pain arise kar rahi thi wo viscera and that part of the body jahan pe wo refer hui hai both have same origin. They receive sensory signals from the same segment of the spinal cord. ठीक है, तो जो न्यूरॉन्स हैं इसका मतलब प्रेजेंट इन द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, दे रिसीव सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम द विसरास एंड दे ऑल्सो रिसीव द सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम द स्किन. तो एक स्पाइनल सेगमेंट जो है इट इज इनर्वेटिंग, इट इज सप्लाइंग, इट इज रिसीविंग सेंसरी सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम द विसरा एज वेल एज इट इज रिसीविंग सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम द स्किन. तो पेन सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम द विसरास आर रेफर टू द एरिया ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द बॉडी हैविंग द सेम डर्माटोलॉजिकल ओरिजिन. And when there is stimulation of the visceral pain fibers, it causes the irradiation of these pain signals to the neurons receiving the signals from the skin. उसी spinal segment के अंदर आपके पास neurons हैं जो के receive कर रहे हैं विसरास से, और neurons हैं which are receiving the signals from the surface of the skin. जब visceral pain fibers are stimulated, उनसे neurons stimulate होते हैं and there is irradiation. Means spread of the pain signals to the neurons receiving signals from the skin. That's why the pain is also felt in the skin. So this is the basis of the referred pain. Now coming to the examples of the referred pain. The examples of the referred pain include the cardiac pain, like cardiac pain or pain of myocardial ischemia. It is referred to the shoulder, it is referred to the neck on the same side, to the lower jaw and the medial surface of the arm till the little finger. So cardiac pain is referred to these sites because these areas of the skin and the heart have the same dermatological origin. They receive sensory supply from the same segment of the spinal cord. So here it is written, heart muscles causes the chest pain which radiate to jaw, here at the lower jaw, shoulder and the left arm on the same side, that is, and medial surface till the little finger. So this is because of the fact that they have the same dermatological origin. Now the other example is the gallbladder. Pain of the gallbladder, it is referred to the tip of the right scapula. So it is the actual site of the pain is right quadrant of the abdomen and it is referred to, it is also felt in the scapular area on the back, especially at the lower tip of the scapula. So these are the two examples of the referred pain. So that's all for today. Because we have finished the pain sensation as well, I hope you understand the lecture. In the next session we are going to talk about the thermal sensation and we will start with the sensory tracts in the spinal cord, which are the ascending tracts which carry the sensations from the periphery to the central nervous system. Thank you for the listening.